Good afternoon, Bobcats, and welcome to BBTV, your home for Buffett News. Today is Tuesday, February 27, 2018. My name is Izzy, bringing you the news that matters. As always, let's begin with the daily announcements. Attention 8th graders traveling to NYC. A mandatory parent meeting will be held tonight in the library from 5:30 to 6:45 p.m. It is important that a parent or adult attends this meeting with you. If you have any questions, please see Ms. Rosenberg or Mr. Doherty. Students, as a reminder, the 7-8 chorus concert that was supposed to happen last week has been rescheduled for tonight in the cafeteria at 7 p.m. Come back to Buffett tonight to hear some amazing singing. Bobcats, you are invited to attend the PTO Buffett Family Night. The event of fun is this Friday, March 2nd from 5 to 7 p.m. All activities will be located in the cafe, gym, and commons. There will be games, food for sale, and inflatables, including the Toxic Meltdown. The event is free, but donations are accepted. Please bring your families, wear comfortable clothes, and get ready for some fun. That's it for the announcements today, Bobcats. Now let's head over to Brandon for a quick news story and an interview of a lifetime our reporters recently landed.
This past Wednesday, we had a very special guest here at Buffett. Legendary Husker coach Tom Osborne sat down with a couple of our very own Bobcats. One of our BBTV reporters, Arnold Pokrell, invited the former coach to be interviewed. The focus of the sit-down interview was to learn about his teammates' program, which is set up to mentor kids all around the Midwest and even right here at Buffett. The second topic was about all of the changes to the Husker program and what he expects out of the new coach, Scott Frost. Two professional news organizations, KMTV3 and KETV7, were both on the location covering the story of us interviewing Tom Osborne. Helping out Arnov with the interview was BBTV reporter Bryce Johnson, who serves as a photographer for the event. The interview that our students filmed is currently being edited and will air on BBTV very soon. However, both KETV and KMTVs aired their versions that night to the entire city of Omaha. Check out what they had to say.
It was an interview times two. We caught up with kids this morning, getting the scoop on a well-known Nebraskan.
Broadcasting students at Buffett Middle School got to meet with former Nebraska football coach and U.S. Congressman Tom Osborne this morning. He was part of a class project for them. Eighth grader Arnav Pokrell actually came up with the idea, researching a story about Osborne's teammates' mentoring program.
I was kind of nervous at first, but as I got used to it, it was an amazing experience.
Yeah, I thought it was really cool that Arnav got this whole thing set up and just got him to actually come here. Just filming him was absolutely amazing.
Big TV station, huh?
That's some good reporting, guys. As you can see, all sides were pretty happy with the experience. Osborne even stuck around afterwards to sign a couple autographs.
Next generation of reporters here at KETV.
There you go.
Legend makes a huge impression. A teacher assigned two eighth graders at Alice Buffett Middle School in Northwest Omaha with interviewing somebody for a school project.
One student chose Tom Osborne, and to the student's surprise, Osborne accepted. Reporter Maya Sines was there for their interview and then interviewed them about their exciting school project. Maya?
Yeah, Craig, Jen, what started out as a school assignment has now turned into a possible career venture for the two students.
Lights, camera, mic check. That's what 8th graders Arnav Pokrell and Bryce Johnson spent their morning checking at their middle school library Wednesday morning before their big one-on-one interview with former Nebraska football coach Dr. Tom Osborne.
Dr. Osborne, this is Arnav.
I'm Arnav.
He's the student who's
set everything
up. Nice
to meet you.
How are you?
For a broadcasting class assignment, the boys were assigned to interview someone and film it.
Just filming them was absolutely amazing. Just seeing how he reacted to the questions and all that, it was just absolutely amazing.
Pokrell asked Osborne about his teammates' mentoring program, which is implemented in his middle school. And of course, new Nebraska football coach, Scott Frost.
I was kind of nervous at first, but as I got used to it, it was an amazing experience.
Arnav came to me. This was after we interviewed Trev Albersley. I'm like, okay, it's a new semester. What do you want to do for a news package this year? And he's like, I'll think about it. And then the next day, I think he came back to me and he's like, I got an interview with Tom Osborne. Is that going to be okay? And I'm like, what? Is that going to be okay? Yeah, yeah, it will be.
Pockrell reached out to Osborne months ago, and Osborne told me he agreed to do it because he likes speaking to youth.
Really impressed with the questions asked, and obviously these guys are well prepared and have really thought it through.
The boys say they got the interview of a lifetime.
It made me think. It made me sweat a little bit.
And also a picture with the football legend.
Yeah, someday you'll be working for a big TV station, huh?
It's changed my perspective on like how I see the news now, because we see all the things that happen, that have to happen, and like all the things that you guys record, and it's definitely changed my view.
Now the boys say Scott Frost might be next. Now Tom Osborne signed the paper where the boys had typed up their questions. That paper will now be framed and put up along the wall, along with the other interviewee signatures in their broadcasting classroom. Reporting live from the studio, Maya Sines, 3 News Now.
All right, Maya, good story. You know, we work in a business that's very practical. You can't really teach it in a book or explain it to somebody. You have to do it to experience it.
Yeah, and I love that when picked for this project, they decided Tom Osborne. They basically said, we want to go for the top. Why not?
And the coach enjoyed it.
I love it.
What's up, Bobcats? This is Kanaya here in the Sports Zone to get you updated on all things sports. Today is Tuesday, which means it's time for your BBTV weekend recap, where we look at the big games over the weekend. Today we are going to focus on the Olympics, which officially wrapped up. How did the U.S. and other countries end up? Let's find out by looking at the medal counts. In first place was Norway, who dominated the Olympics, earning 39 medals. Second place is the country of Germany with 31 medals. And third place is Team Canada with 29 medals. Finally, Team USA places fourth with 23 medals. Moving on to local sports, tonight after school we have a big girls basketball game as our rivals, the Davis Aviators, come to Buffett for an intense battle. Be sure to tune into a future episode of BBTV for all the coverage. That's all the time in the Sports Zone. Now over to the Entertainment Corner.
Good afternoon, Bobcats. This is Sean bringing you coverage of everything important to you in your free time. Welcome to the Entertainment Corner. Today we're going to be checking out the world of online gaming. Fortnite is an online game that is having tons of buzz with students of Buffett. Last Thursday, a very important event came to the game as the Season 3 Battle Pass was released. The Battle Pass is a way to earn exclusive loot and items for the game. In Season 3, you can purchase this item for $10, giving you access to 6 outfits, 4 pickaxes, 3 diving trails, and a new gun, the hand cannon. The pass will also be going all the way up to 100 tiers.
Bobcats, this is Elizabeth, and it looks like the wheel has landed on I Want That. This means that we'll be telling you about an item a lot of people like to buy. The focus of today is bath bombs. This is a popular trend that has recently taken off that gives you a fun way to liven up your bath. For today's feature, we are going to show you how to make your own. Check out this fun and easy DIY. What you're going to need is baking soda, Epsom salt, citric acid, essential oil, food coloring, water, olive oil, a small dish or jar, a big bowl, and a whisk.
that's going to do it for our broadcast today, Bobcats. For more info on many of the stories you've heard and to see what we're working on for future episodes, be sure to follow our Twitter page at BuffettBBTV. Signing off, this has been Izzy. Have a terrific day, Bobcats.